Hey everyone, welcome back. We have an update to the Qwen Image Edit model. This is the Qwen Image Edit Rapid All-in-One, and it is basically a merge between the model VA clip. There's also the Lightning 4-step LoRa in it. Basically, you can download one model and get the capabilities of 4 models in one. It can do the job of the base Qwen Image Edit model. It can also do the Qwen Image Edit 2509 functionalities by doing text to image, image to image, and we can have up to 3 different images. Because we have this Lightning LoRa in it, we'll be using one CFJ, 4 steps. It is the FP8 Precision, and we have 2 versions, a safe for work and a not safe for work version. This post is a little bit outdated. Right now, at the time of recording, the model version is at 7. In the description of this video, you will get a link. Click on it. It will take you to Hugging Face page and you can see the entire post. At the very bottom will be the latest version. Right now, it's at version 7. We can see it has the 2509 and includes the LoRAs in it. Now go all the way to the top to download the model. You'll need to click on files and versions. Ignore everything that is down here. These are outdated. We'll go inside the version 7. If you're watching this 1 week or 2 weeks in the future, it's possible that there's a version 8 there. And actually, just 2 minutes ago, we got yet another update. This time it's version 7.1. This is how rapid these models are coming out. For me, I've already downloaded the version 7. You can go ahead and download the version 7.1 if you wish. Simply click on these download buttons to download the file. Now next, update your ComfyUI. Go inside of ComfyUI and we're going to see how this new model works. This is a typical Qwen Image Edit 2509 workflow. And what we will be doing is replacing this model section here with the new model. Basically, we'll get the functionality of 4 models in one. So we'll start with a load checkpoint and you will need to have your checkpoint. So hopefully you've downloaded yours. Go into your ComfyUI folder. You will need to paste that model into ComfyUI models. This time you will go inside the checkpoints folder. Normally the Qwen Image Edit goes inside the Diffusion models. This new version will go inside the checkpoints one. Now, because we are on YouTube right now, I will be showcasing the safe for work version. Once you have your model in the correct folder, go inside of ComfyUI and press R on your keyboard. This will refresh the node definitions and you should be able to find your model from the list here. Select it, the model, take it out, drag out, go inside a key sampler. For the positive and negative, take the positive out, and we will need the Qwen Image Edit plus text encoder. So select this one, duplicate it down. The bottom one will be the negative prompt. Now we will not be using negative prompt for this model. So this one will stay blank. We'll connect the clip. We'll also need the VAE. Latent image is going to be an empty latent image node. And then you can take the latent out for a VAE decode. And then just take the VAE directly here. The image can be a preview image or a save image node. And this is how simple this new version looks when it comes to Qwen Image Edit 2509. Now let's take a look at how to do text to image. Right now, this is a typical text to image. For example, I can do a simple prompt. I'm saying a woman with a flower on top of an elephant. And very important, in the case sampler here, we'll change the number of steps to 4 and the CFG will be 1.0. For the sampler, we'll go with the SA solver, and then the scheduler, you can start with beta. I'm going to fix the seed and you can generate. All right, this is your text to image workflow. And we have the woman on top of an elephant. Now, obviously you can change your size in here. Now let's take a look at how to do image to image. Very easy, we'll add a load image node. And let's say you want this woman to be on top of the elephant. We'll take the image and connect it with image one. We'll do the same with the negative prompt, but just fix the resolution here. You can also go a different resolution if you want to. And this here becomes your image to image workflow. The only thing that will change in terms of the prompt is the phrasing. Because we have an image, I'm saying put image one woman on top of the elephant. Now we have that woman on top. Okay, so what if you want to have two? The process is going to be the same. You'll duplicate it. This is image one. This will become image two. And we'll need to connect it like this. Let's say, for example, we want a background. Okay, now we are using two images, image one, image two, and we have our final output combination of these two. Of course, you can continue and use a third image. You can, of course, do masking. You can also do character face swapping. All of that functionality stays the same. It's just that now we'll be using a load checkpoint instead of this group here where we need load diffusion model, LoRa, clip, and VAE as separate models. So I went ahead and checked all of these combined plus the base model and the other versions of the Qwen image edit. All of those models took around 84 gigabytes for me. Of course, if you have version 1, 2, 3, and 4, all of that will take even more space. This one, it's only 30 gigabytes in size. So I think this is a big plus. You should definitely use this version. And if you need the uncensored version, there's also the not safe for work version. All right, thank you for watching until the very end. I'm going to go ahead and modify my previous workflows. This is the character generation, the 4 views. There's also the 9 view consistent character workflow that I'll be modifying and sharing on my free Patreon page. You can click on the link in the description below. Join it to get that update if you don't want to make the modification yourself. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Take care. I will see you next time.